Hello techies, in our previous tutorial we have learned how to read data from Excel file by using a SQL connection which is provided by the OLE provider. Now as a second topic, we will learn how to filter the records from the Excel. Let me show you a small use case over here. In my employee list Excel file, I want to retrieve employee ID, employee name by filtering the records whose female employee salary is greater than 50,000 and belong to the state code India, who is joining date between 2000 and 2014. This is my small use case. If you see over here in my EMP underscore personal underscore details worksheet, I'm having employee ID, name and gender. If you go for employee underscore salary underscore details worksheet, I'm having employee ID, state code, joining date, and annual salary. Now, as per our use case, we need to retrieve employee ID and name from the worksheet one, that is employee underscore personal details. But the filter is that the gender we are having, right? That the gender, we need to filter that only for the female employees and the salary. If you see in my employee underscore salary details, I want to filter the employee salary, annual salary, whose salary is greater than 50,000. And then the state code belongs to India. These are the filters that we have. Along with that, the joining date should be between 2000 and 2014. This is my small use case over here. But if you observe over here, there are a lot of things are there to filter out. One is that the condition should be gender equal to female. That is my first filtering condition, right? And the second filter condition, you can see the numbers over here that I'm going to give the salary over here, which is greater than 50,000. I'm going to check the condition like greater than and female equal to and gender equal to female is my another filter. And then the state code, I'm going to give it as India over there. And also we are comparing the joining date between two dates, that is greater than 2000 and less than 2014, like between 2000 and 2014. These are the values between two dates that we are going to mention. How can I go ahead and filter the records using Excel as a database? Now, in my execute SQL statement, I have already given the SQL statement in a such a way to retrieve the data. That is select star from EMP underscore personal underscore details. That is alias name, I have given it as EPD. Inner joining with another table, employee underscore salary details. That is alias name, I have given it as ESD. And on condition, I'm going to join these two tables. That is EPD.EmployeeID comparing with ESD.EmployeeID. Right? Now, we'll take one by one filter condition. As the first filter condition, I need to check where gender equal to female, right? I'm going to pass the condition over here. I'm going to start where EPD. So the gender is available in my employee underscore personal details, right? So that I'm going to give EPD dot gender equal to female. So this is my first filter, right? Now let me click on save. And then let's run the flow to see the output for gender. Flow execution started. There you can see, based on the condition, what is the condition we have given, where employee ID equal to female. So this will execute SQL statement, executes the data, and then it will give the results in the query result. Let's double click on the query result inside my flow variables. Let's double click on that. There you can see, if you see the filter, I have given EPD.EmployeeID that I have given select star, means all the columns I have to get it, right? So that you can see over here, the EPD.EmployeeID, name, gender, again, employee ID from the another worksheet, that is ESD, alias name, and the state code, joining date, and annual salary. There, if you scroll down, I'm having almost all 499 rows that I'm having. All are with the gender equal to female, right? This is my first filter condition. Now, as a second condition, what I have to do, I need to get the state code only that belongs to India. So then, where is this state code that we have? In my epd.state code, in my second worksheet, right? That is employee underscore salary underscore details. I'm going to add the condition, one more condition by giving and. And there, I'm going to give ESD, that is employee underscore salary underscore details. Inside that, I'm having state code. So what is the state code? I'm going to give it, I want to filter the records based on state code equal to India. Now, if you see, I'm going to give two conditions. First one is the gender, another one, the state code should be India. All right, let's click on save. And let's run the flow once again to see the output. Flow execution started. Now, if you see, based on the filter condition, what we have given, gender equal to female and state code equal to India, it has given the results over here. Now, if you see the query result, I'm having only 8 rows as an output. The reason is that we had almost all 499 records with the gender equal to female. But again, we have applied another condition, that is state code equal to India. It has to satisfy both the conditions. One is gender equal to female, another one state code equal to India. Now, based on the filter again, I got only 8 records or 8 rows. All are female, and then you can see state code equal to India. All right, now let's click on close. Now, we have one more filter condition, that is between the dates, right? So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to modify this execute SQL statement once again, and I'm going to add one more filter, that is and condition that I want to add it. So the joining date should be between 2004 and 2014. In between these two dates, if any gender is available as female and state code is equal to India, I need to get all the records. So the joining date is available inside my employee underscore salary underscore details. And I'm going to give the joining date at the column. So it should be 2004 and 2014, right? Then I'm going to use the keyword that is between. I'm going to start hash whenever I'm going to give the dates over here. That is January 1st, 2004. And I'm going to close with hash again. And then I'm going to add and condition again. So between and, whenever you're going to use joining date. And then I'm going to give again hash 31/12/2014. And I'm going to close with hash again. Now, whenever you are going to give the joining dates, you have to give the keywords between and. And I'm going to give the start date and the end date. Now, if you observe, it is trying to filter. It has to satisfy all the conditions. One is gender, state code, and joining date. And then based on these filter conditions, it will get the results. All right, let's click on save. And then once again, let's run the flow to see the output. Flow execution started. There you can see it is trying to execute the SQL statement based on the given filters. And then it will store the output in the query result. Let me open the query result flow variable. There you can see I have only one record over here. So what are the conditions that I have given over here? First thing is gender equal to female. Yes, it is satisfied. And the joining date, you can see over here, the joining date we have given the condition as 2004 to 2014. Now the joining date in between that, yes, it is also satisfied. And the another condition, the state code is India, that is also satisfied, all right? Based on the given filters, we got the output. How many records? If it is gender equal to female, in that case, we got 499 records. Then we have applied one more condition, that is state code equal to India. In that case, we got 8 rows. Now, again, we have applied one more condition, that is joining date in between 2004 to 2014. Then we got a single record, which is Edison Gosen in the details with the employee ID 1330, right? Now, we have to get only the employee ID and the name of the particular details based on the filter condition. But we are showing all the columns over here. In that case, how can we go ahead and filter it based on the given columns? What are the required columns? Let me click on close. Let me once again open the execute SQL statement. Now, at the final part, we need to retrieve the specific column, that is employee ID and the employee name. So employee ID is available in the EPD, that is employee underscore personal details, as well as employee underscore salary details worksheet also. Now you can get it from anywhere because of we are using the join condition, that is the inner join, and the employee ID equal to employee ID condition, right? So that what I'm going to do, I'm going to use EPD, or I will give ESD dot employee ID. I'm going to give alias as employee ID. Okay, I'm going to mentioning the alias name. And then I have to display the employee name from the where it is available inside my EPD only. So I'm going to make it comma EPD dot, where is the employee name? There you can see I'm having in my Excel, I'm having name, right? So that I'm going to get it as name, EPD dot name. I'm going to give alias name as employee name, right? So that we'll get only these two columns while I'm going to filter our entire data. All right, let's click on save. Now, once again, let's run the flow to see the output. Flow execution started. Now, it is trying to retrieve the data by using execute SQL statement based on the given conditions and the specific columns by using the SQL queries. Flow has executed successfully. Now, if you observe under the flow variables, I got the query results. Previously, I got one row, but columns are seven. But right now, if you double click on that, we have mentioned only two columns in our execute SQL statement, correct? That is employee ID, I have given it as alias name, and the employee name, I have given it as alias name. This employee ID, we got it from the employee underscore salary underscore details, whereas the employee name, we got it from the employee underscore personal underscore details worksheet. All right, let me click on close. I hope you understand how to retrieve the specific columns by filtering the records, such as gender, and the salary which is greater than 5,000, and the state code, and also by applying the joining date between 2000 and 2014 in this small use case.